Hello guys, welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demonstration on analog and digital IC tester. IC testers are very useful in the industry where the ICs are being used. So testing the IC before putting it in any circuit is very beneficial for reducing the time in R&D or whether it is in testing. Because that the ICs are already tested and it's are working in good condition, so we can put the production and the complete overall cost of the production with the less consuming time will be very highly appreciable with the use of IC testers. So IC tester is basically a device which works on the microcontroller based programming with some of course electronic circuits, and some testing procedure of different type of libraries are stored in the IC testers and the microcontroller in the ROM of microcontroller, so that we can put any of the IC number which are prescribed for the any of IC tester device, and then the procedure for IC testing will be followed according to the instruction saved in the microcontroller, and then the IC will be tested whether it is good or bad. So good ICs can be used in any of the circuit, whether for the store taking. We can test the ICs while after purchasing and before putting them in the stores, so that any production line will be provided only good ICs after testing. In this video, I am going to explain the complete parts of the IC tester, what is it capable of and what type of ICs you can test from this. This is basically an analog and digital ICs, so most of the analog and digital type of ICs we can test with this. So after that, we will also see the basic sample IC testing for understanding the complete procedure of IC testing. So now we move on to the complete component and circuit description of the IC tester, and later on we will be do some sample testing of ICs. So this is the close overlook of this analog and digital IC tester. The order code is 68005. You can use this order code to find out all the specification about this and what can be it offer and capable of this IC tester by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. Now I will explain you the basic features of this analog and digital IC tester. It has the facility to test the most of the 6, 8, 10, 14, 16, 18, 20, 24, 28 and 40 pin ICs in the DIP package. The IC is available in the round pack if it is in pin compatible with the DIP counterpart. They can be tested in this system after bending the ICs with the DIP package pitch. The list includes are given in the user manual. You can follow it also. Some of the list includes are 7454 ICs, 4540 ICs, 9396 series ICs, EPROMs, RAMs, peripheral ICs, 8-bit and 16-bit microprocessor like 8085, 8086, 8085, Z8T6502, operational amplifiers, voltage comparators, transistor arrays, optocouplers, analog switches, voltage followers, timers, analog to digital converters, digital to analog converters and miscellaneous linear ICs also. Automatic testing of the variety of the ICs. It does not require any add-on plug-in hardware for each type of ICs. It is also an important and interesting feature of this IC tester. Then potentially 20 pin ZIF socket for testing ICs, and also linear ICs 40 pin universal zero insertion force ZIF socket for testing digital ICs are also provided. LCD dot matrix display will provide a friendly interaction with the user. 24 feather touch keys keyboard with the descriptive engraving of its functions along with the help key enables to operate the unit even without the technical operations manual. Help key is provided for the helping of easy operation. Facility to test the IC only once or continuous until it is stopped. Single step mode also provided given with the feather touch keys. The system remembers the device number for testing more than the same type of ICs with the same device number pressing a single key. Self-test facility to test the internal modules and internal circuitry with the IC tester automatically at power on, and also with the self-test key also provided. Over here, audio buzzer for bringing the user attention whenever it is required is also provided in this IC tester, and expansion of test library can be made possible through the RS232 serial interface provided, separate key functions is available to invoke this. The RS232 connector is behind on the ICE tester. Now this was the basic features that I have explained of this ICs. Now we will see all the key components, the ZIF socket working, and all key, what the keys and different commands of this IC tester using that, and we will see working with this some basic ICs. The IC testers work on the IC tester basically works on the 220 volt AC power supply, so which is provided with this power cord. You can connect it to any of the 220 volt AC sockets. The plug-in socket is also provided behind of the IC tester. So we'll connect it to the 220 volt power supply, and as I connect it, it will be automatically turned on, and also there is a on-off switch provided on the behind, so you can on and off the IC tester with the switch as well. So as the IC tester is on, it will automatically self-test all the components first, and then you are ready to do the testing with any of the IC. So now I am going to explain you all the working of all the keys that are provided on the keyboard. This is a 24 key feather touch keyboards. So we will see working of all the functions one by one. So we will start with the 0 to 9 key. These are to enter the IC number numeric data. So 0 to 9 keys, these are the integer keys for entering the number. You can enter any of the number using like 741, 212, any of the number of ICs you can enter. After that we have the backspace or the right cursor arrow. So this will delete the last entered numeric data. As I press, all the data in the backspace mode will be deleted as we do in the computers generally. Then we have clear mode. So if you want to clear the complete screen of IC number as I have entered for the example, so when we press clear, all the data or all the details of any of the IC number will be completely clear from the screen. Then we have about key. About key is to abort any of the current functions. So likely if we enter any of the IC entering number, and if I press abort, this will also delete the keys, and again we can enter any of the other number. And if any of the testing is going on, like we self test, and if you press abort, after self testing abort will be provided. Then we have one and continuous mode. The one to set the mode on one mode, when we press, the IC will tested in single mode. One IC will be tested easily, and when we turn this to the continuous mode, both the modes will be turned by pressing the single key for toggling the functions from both of them, and we can do vice versa of that. And by pressing the keys to changes mode from one to continuous and vice versa. For this, in the continuous mode we can enter the IC number first with any of the number, and when we start testing it will give you the output on this. So right now IC is not connected on the ZIF socket, that's why it's showing the sorry not found number or the sorry not found message. When you press abort, we again go to IC So if you reach and continuous mode any of the non IC number that you have entered, so for that, for coming out from this situation, you just need to turn off the kit and again turn it on. You will be reached again to the home screen. Now moving on to the some other keys. Then we have test key. The test key starts the test operation in one or continuous mode and display the result in case of one mode or the number of times the IC has been passed in the continuous mode. This will be provided on the screen. Now we move to the next key, which is the step key. The step key tests the ICs in steps, so we can test the ICs in number of steps. All the steps of the and result of the every steps will be displayed on the IC. We will see it in the testing procedure while we test with some of the ICs for sample. Then we have auto search option. The auto search option locates the digital IC numbers up to 20 pins. So auto search option is very useful while working the auto searching of the IC number, or you it can result output in the equivalent IC that you are entering for that, whatever it determines through this programming of the microcontrollers. Then we have self-test key. The self-test key is to test the correctness of internal module and when it is required. So self-testing will be a complete procedure of testing hardware internally, and after software and hardware is tested, this will give you acknowledgement as a check buzzer for the user. Then we have pause key. Before that, I will explain you the help key. Pause key will be explained with the help key option. So help key is used for eliminating the need of user manual. Describe the function of the subsequent press button or the key in the short form on the LCD display. So right now, as I pressed help, and it will asking me to press a key, and as I press any of the key on the keyboard, it will give me the working or the basic function in short of the on the LCD display. So as I press clear for that, IC number will be cleared in the key when it is pressed. Also, the pause key that I am asking, this will pause the scrolling screen on the LCD, whatever the message is flashing and scrolling, so that you can easily read out all the message in the proper manner. So help key is used for checking out the function in the short form of the IC. Single step testing under the test procedure will be going on through this. So this is all about the basic keys. Then we have some function keys, F1, F2, F3 and F4. The F3 key will be required while you want to expand the complete library of the IC tester, the already prescribed IC that you can test. If you want to expand the IC tester memory, you just need to enter the code. The code will be provided from the company, or you can generate the code for the testing of library by your own, and after that you can communicate and download the codes in the microcontroller provided on the IC tester, connecting it with the RS-232 communication protocol. The RS-232 communication protocol connector is provided on behind of this IC tester, and after connecting it, press the F3 key and you can go to the serial mode communication. F1, F2 and F4 keys are provided for expansion of the functions that you are going to program through the microcontroller after communicating it. So this is the basic description and overview about all the keys. Now we will see some sample IC testing in single mode and also in the continuous mode, and some different type of ICs which libraries are given in the user manual. The user manual that you can refer, in which all the library and IC that can be testable from this IC tester are given. I will give you a basic look of that also. So this is the type of ICs covered in this. Digital 20 pin dip sockets provided are given. Testing methods are also given in this user manual. You can follow it properly. And the test library of order code 68005 is provided, in which the digital ICs of 74 and 54 series are covered. These are the number of ICs that you can test from this. 4045 series of ICs are also provided. These are the ICs described that you can test. 9396 series also, microprocessor, EEPROM, RAM and other digital ICs that are included in this library are also given in this user manual. Similarly, we have some linear ICs like operational amplifier, comparators, transistor arrays, optocouplers, analog switches, voltage followers, timers, analog to digital converter, digital to analog converters, cross point switches and miscellaneous ICs. These are all the libraries which are already installed in this order code, so that you can test any of the ICs given in this user manual from this IC tester. So now we start first testing the IC sampling. For this, we will start with the operational amplifiers. For this, we are going to test the LM series ICs, LM324, that we have already. So this is the LM324 ICs right now with me. So we'll put this in the ZF socket like this. Always put the bottom of IC with the bottom of ZF socket. Lock this properly with this lever and enter the number 324, which is our IC number for this, and press test, and it will result that the IC is good in the LM324, this IC. Similarly, you can test the ICs in the 40 pin sockets also. 40 pin sockets is provided for the bigger ICs up to 40 pin, more than 20 pin series, but you can test them into also with the lower pin IC also. So 324 that we am entering, and in the step mode we can test it also. So this is first the single mode complete testing, and in the step mode again if I enter the IC number and press step key, so step 1 is good for this, step 2 is good, step 3 resulted good, step 4 good, step 5 good, step 6 good, and any of the step at which the IC is faulted, find faulty, it will give you the bad and complete testing will be gone bad of the IC. Step 8 will be good, step 9 good, step 10 good, step 11, 12, 13, 14. So all the step by step testing will be happen. So complete testing is done right now with this. So this is how we can test the ICs in good and step in complete testing mode with this. Now similarly, moving to the next option, we will test a comparator IC. For this I have a IC LM393 for this, so we'll test it from the IC tester. Put this ICs in the ZF socket, properly lock it and enter 393. This is the comparator IC and we test it. Just press the test key and the output is good. So this is how the comparator IC LM393 is tested. You can clear this and pull back the IC after testing. Now similarly, I have the optocoupler IC, the MCT2, that I am going to enter in the ZF socket, and for testing it just need to enter the digit 2, as the MCT2 is the only numeric digit in this IC, and when you press test it will test and give back result as it is good. The MCT2 is the good IC for us. Another MCT2 that we are going to test, and again press test and this will give us the good output. Now similarly, we will test an analog switch IC. For this we are using a IC4051. Put this in the IC socket and enter the IC number 4051 likely and press test. The CD4051, the analog switch, is now tested and it is good. So we can use this in any of the circuit. Similarly, a 40 series IC that we are going to test. This is a 4011, 4011 IC. We'll press this for clearing and try to auto search this. For auto searching, just press about once so that any of the working function will be about and auto search will start working. So it's finding the equivalent IC 7401, which is not our IC. Again we'll press the auto search and let us see what the output is giving. 7439, which is also not our IC. So generally auto searching will only work with the digital ICs. 4011, that is now finded from the auto search option. So that's how we can auto search the ICs. Now we'll press the test key, the IC number that is auto searched right now. So we'll press about and now I enter the IC number 4011 and press test. The IC is good. That's how we can test the ICs. Now, now for seeing the so this so also